And last but not least, we've got Zed or Z. How do I say that? Zed. Z. Zed. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel and to another video. So it's been about a month since I've done a sit-down video because I've been super busy, but also last week I had COVID, so I just did a vlog. But yeah, today I'm back at doing a sit-down video with you guys, and I'm going to be doing a get-to-know-me video because it has been a long time since I've done anything remotely like that, like a get-to-know-me or 20 facts about me. I've done two 20 facts about me videos, and if you want to check them out, I will put them up here. But for this video today, I got the idea from my friend Fiona, and she did this on her YouTube channel. Go subscribe to her, I will link her down below. She did a get-to-know-me A to Z, and I was like, you know what, this is a good idea. I'm gonna do this too, because like I said, it's been a while since I've introduced myself on this channel, and there might be some new people. In fact, there are some new people here, so welcome if you are new here, and thanks for joining my little YouTube fam. So without further ado, let's get into Get to Know Me A to Z. So some of these were very challenging, and then some of them, there were multiple things I wanted to put down, so I've tried to include everything that I wanted to include, but like tried to figure out what other words I can put them under and things like that. So let's just dive into it. And the letter A is for animal, and I'm taking this as my favorite animal, and that is a dolphin. And I do have a dolphin related video that has been in the works. Well, it's been at a standstill kind of, but it has been in the works since Mallorca, and I will get around to finishing and making that video soon. But yeah, dolphins are my favorite animals, and I saw them in Mallorca. Yeah, I've got a special video on that planned at some stage. B is for Belgium because I am half Belgian. My mum is from Brussels. C is for creativity and creating, basically, and that kind of like covers sewing, arts and crafts, makeup, I guess, as well. Just anything creative, writing, baking, making videos, anything where I am creating comes under letter C because I couldn't fit them all in on the other letters. D is for desserts. Again, I wanted to put chocolate down, but I had already put something down for letter C, and that was the only way I could really get all those things like baking and everything into the list. So D is for desserts. Oh, desserts. I love desserts, and I love baking desserts, like I said in the last one. I love baking. And also chocolate, because chocolate is one of my favorite things ever. I'm half Belgian, you know. I love chocolate, especially Belgian chocolate. E is for environment, because I care about the environment and about being eco-friendly. F is for French, because I speak French from my Belgian side. G is for Gwendolyn, that's my sister's name. H is for Harry Potter, because I am a huge fan, and I'm a Ravenclaw. I wanted to fit that in the list, but I had already put something down for, so yeah. Squeezing it in here. I is for Ireland, my other half. I am half Irish, half Belgian. If my accent wasn't already a telltale sign, although I know my accent has changed a lot, especially having lived in London, so I have gotten Canadian. Some people think I'm Canadian. That's got nothing to do with this letter, but there you go. J is for jazz, because I love jazz, I love music, and I went to a jazz club recently for my birthday, which there is a bit of a vlog footage in my last sit down video, which I will link up here and down below in the description box. And it was kind of an update video on what I've been up to, and I included some footage from my birthday. K was a bit hard, and I was kind of like, okay, what do I put for K? And then, you know, I was looking up words, and I was like, kaleidoscope. I just remember we had this kaleidoscope when we were kids, and I remember enjoying looking through it. It was just in the living room, and sometimes I'd just go and pick it up and look at it when I was a kid. And K also stands for kid, a memory from my childhood. So K stands for that memory, I guess. L is for listening to music. Again, literally, I couldn't think of anything, and I didn't want to do the one that my friend Fiona had done, which was Leaping Bunny, because I wanted to change things up and do it differently, and like not copy her. But so I just like, just before filming this video, I was like, what can I put? Okay, listening music. Listening to music, because as I said earlier, I love music. I grew up in a musical household, so I was constantly surrounded by music, and I love to listen to music, and I mostly listen to like Disney and show tunes, so yeah. Emma is from musical theater, and if you haven't watched my channel before, basically I love musical theater and I am a huge musicals nerd, and I am a performer myself. So, yeah, musical theater. There's nothing else to say really about musical theater. N is for nature, and I just wanted to mention the sea because I couldn't get the sea in on the list. And I grew up by the sea, and I just love fresh air, and nature's beautiful, so why not add it to the list? There's honestly nothing like being out in fresh air, either by the sea or in the mountains, in the countryside. There's just nothing like it really. O is for original songs because I write my own music. And some of them are on Spotify if you'd like to check them out. And I want to do more, I want to write more. I started writing a song this year and I need to get back to that. So expect more original music to come. But yes, that's something I love to do. I love writing songs. Moving on to P, we've got pizza. Because it's my favorite food, I guess. No, I love loads of different types. Like, there's lots of food that I love, but pizza is, there's something about pizza. I make my own pizza normally every week. I wrote a song about it once. If you want to check it out, I will link it down below or up here. Q was another difficult one. I know Fiona struggled with this one as well. I picked the word qualification because I literally did not know what else to pick, so I went with that. And my qualification is musical theater. Obviously. R is for reading because I love reading, and I recently finished a book called The Family Upstairs by Lisa Jewell, and I highly recommend it. It is very good. And then S is for Sarah because that's my name. It's a bit far into the video to introduce myself, but hi, my name is Sarah, if you didn't know that already. And yeah, that's my name. It means princess, which is pretty cool. And there's not much else to say, really. Let's go on to the next letter. T is for TV shows, and then in brackets I wrote, and movies, because I didn't know where else to put movies. Yeah, I love watching TV shows. If we were to go through every TV show I love, we'd be here all day. I'm currently watching Fuller House. I started watching it like quite a few years ago and kind of stopped. And now I've started watching it again. What did I just finish? I watched recently, what's it called? The Woman in the House Across the Street from the Girl in the Window. I watched that a couple of weeks ago. Yeah, like a few weeks ago. I watched that. I binged it quite quickly. That was good. What else? I literally have just finished. Oh, I finished watching Sister Sister on Netflix. What else did I watch recently? Oh, Love is Blind. And also Dollface on Disney Plus. There are lots of TV shows that I'm waiting to come back, like Stranger Things, and there's a long list of shows that I'm waiting for them to come back, or if they have already come back, waiting for them to be on Netflix. Moving on. Also, obviously it's not tea, but movies. I love watching movies as well. U is for ukulele, because I play the ukulele. Still, you know, learning. Lots to learn with it, but I do like that it's a very handy and not too difficult instrument that you can just kind of pick up and play along and, you know, sing with. I also play the piano. V was another difficult one, so I went with something that brings up a memory from my childhood again, and that's the word vex. Sounds so weird just out of like context like that, but basically the Secret Garden movie, the one from 1993, so in that one there's a scene where, I think it's Mrs. Medlock. She says, "Don't vex me, child," or she says something like that. I can't remember the exact line. As a kid, I was like, what the heck does that mean? And I just remember my grandmother explaining it to me, and it's just, I always remember just finding it the weirdest word as a kid. I was like, what is this word? Because nobody used it, especially not kids. It's not really used as much. Yeah, I always found that a strange word, so that's the only thing that I could come up with for V, was that memory of being like, every time they said it in the movie, I was like, I found it fascinating, I think, or I don't know what, it was just, let's move on. For W, I have got Walt Disney, because it was the only way I could get Disney in there, and yeah, I love Disney. What's new? X. This is actually one that Fiona did, so sorry Fiona for stealing it, but X is a hard one to think of, and that's x-rays. And I've had lots of x-rays in my life, for my cleft, dental x-rays as well. And one x-ray that I got a lot was the one, I don't think they do this one anymore, or they don't do it the way that they used to do it, which was, it was like the size of a credit card. I don't know if I've said this, like if I've told this on my channel before, but it's the size of a credit card, and they put it in your mouth, and they shove it back real far, and it really makes you gag. And I had that loads, that was a dental one, and I had that loads growing up, and it was horrible every time. But then I think they've gravitated more towards the one that just kind of just goes between your teeth, and it's like a big one that moves around you. Because I haven't had the credit card, it's not a credit card, but I haven't had that one in a long time, so I don't think that they do that one anymore. I'm not sure actually, but yes, I've had a lot of x-rays for non-cleft things as well, like when I hurt my back in 2016. Yeah, I fell on my back on the step, and just in my house, and it was still hurting a while later, so I got an x-ray for that. I can't remember when, like a couple of months later, and that's x-rays. So now we're on the second last one, why? And I just chose Yuletide for Christmas, so I could get Christmas in there. I am a Christmas lover. If you've watched my channel before, you shall know this. What's more to say about half these things? They're just things that I love, and I'm like, I don't know what else to say. I love them. And last but not least, we have Zed. And I picked zero waste, because I know I already mentioned environment earlier on, but zero waste is like, in addition to that, I guess it's like a lifestyle that I've been trying to slowly ease my way into, and I'm still not perfect, and I've still got some things that are considered waste or that aren't, that are like plastic but recyclable, but who knows where it actually goes. And yeah, I'm getting there. I have honestly, it's changed my life for the better, and it's a lot easier than you think it is. And once you get stuck into it, there's no going back, you know, and it can be hard sometimes, when you're faced with like a non-zero waste situation that's hard to, that you can't avoid, or, you know, it can be a little bit like conflicting for your like moral compass, I guess. But other than that, yeah, it's been a good experience, and I'm happy to have made all the changes I've made so far. So I highly recommend trying it out, or at least trying to make a part of your life zero waste, or, you know, do a few swaps. I've made videos on them in the past if you want to check them out, to give you ideas, like dental, period, and whatever else I've done. But yeah, that's the end of the alphabet. There are no more letters. I hope I didn't forget a letter, because that would be very awkward. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and you got to know a little bit more about me. And I will see you guys in the next one. Please give a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and check out all my social media handles, which I will put down here. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!